Electric lawnmowers are great. Quieter, more powerful, no toxic fumes or gasoline, and far less maintenance than a gas mower. However, there's another way to level up your electric lawnmower game, and that's with the latest onslaught of robotic mowers hitting the market. Autonomous mowers that use proximity sensors, computer vision, and accurate to the centimeter global positioning systems are everywhere now. Last year, I beta tested a model that's out in the market now, and this year, I bought myself a second one for comparison. And because I have a tech addiction problem, I even have a third. But it's technically not a mower in its current configuration. It's a yard robot with a snowblower attachment that I'm looking forward to testing out next winter. And when I said that these things were everywhere now, maybe I just meant my house. But seriously, how well do these things work, and are they worth it? I'm Matt Ferrell. Welcome to Undecided. This video is brought to you by Surfshark, but more on that later. Cars have had autonomous driver assist features for years now. Add to that autonomous robot vacuums that are kind of ubiquitous at this point. I'm sure many of you have one. My 80-year-old parents even have one. Well, this tech is starting to take on our yards, which is why I wanted to cover this topic. Now, I'm all for sustainable technology, so going electric with our yard equipment is pretty straightforward. Electric also has huge advantages over gas-powered equipment, which I've detailed in the past when I've reviewed electric lawnmowers and snowblowers. So why an autonomous mower? What I have here are the Segway Navimo H1500VF and the Manmotion Luba 2 all-wheel drive 3000H. As I already mentioned, I didn't pay for the Navimo because I was a beta tester last year, but I did buy the Luba 2. In either case, my opinions are my own and neither company has anything to do with this video. I'm assuming the appeal of a robot mower should be obvious. You don't have to spend time mowing your lawn. And for those of you that like mowing your lawn, Godspeed. Now, the problem with previous generations of robot lawnmowers was that they require a perimeter wire. You were supposed to tack down or bury a wire around the edge of your lawn, which would define the boundaries of the area to mow. Installing the wire is time-consuming and can easily be broken by a wayward garden tool or outdoor cat. These new models can use a combination of proximity sensors, computer vision, and RTK global positioning systems for hyper-accurate location tracking. It's the RTK system that's the game changer. The way it works is that you set up a base station somewhere in your yard, which can receive the GPS signals. Now, the robot mower also has built-in GPS antennas, which means it's using two locations as reference points in order to narrow down the precise location to within a centimeter or two. As for the computer vision systems, it's not unlike what you'd find on a modern car like a Tesla, Rivian, or Ford. The mower uses machine learning to recognize objects like people, pets, trees, bushes, in order to either stop for safety or to navigate around the object. There's additional safety features like proximity sensors and pressure-sensitive bumpers, so the mower knows if it's bumped into an object, if there's something close by, or if someone has touched the mower and is trying to lift it. In that case, the mower quickly shuts off the blades to avoid injury. These mowers are extremely safe from my experience. So, speaking of experience, how's the setup? Now, while you don't have to bury a wire around your yard, which is a huge boon, there's still some setup work here. This is something that I see get glossed over a lot in robot mower reviews. It can be tricky to find the ideal location for the base station's RTK antenna and the mower's charging station. Now, this is true of both the Navimo and the Luba 2. The antennas and charging station need power, as well as an unobstructed view of the sky. Depending on where your outside outlets are located and what your house and surrounding situation looks like, if you have a lot of trees, this can be a big challenge. For the Navimo, you only need one power plug to power both the mower's charging station and the RTK antenna. And the reason? Well, the RTK antenna is connected by a long extension wire to the charging station. While it's nice that you only need one outlet, the issue is that you may have to string the wire to the antenna across your lawn to get a clear signal somewhere else. And that means stretching a wire right along the path the mower might need to mow. And just like the previous generation of robot mowers with a perimeter wire, this could easily get cut or damaged, or in my case last year, when I was a beta tester, chewed through by a hungry chipmunk. Now, thankfully, in my case, I have an outlet located in a great location, which makes it easy to keep the wires off the lawn and in relative safety. And these mowers all come with some kind of pole that you can use to stab into the ground to secure it. Now, for the Navimo, I was able to attach the antenna to a mount on the side of my house. That's ideally what you'd want to do. It keeps it out of the way, clear line of sight to the sky, and very safe. Now, this is where the Luba 2 actually comes out slightly ahead. But before I get into what that advantage is, I need to talk about another piece of tech that can really help your daily digital life, and that's today's sponsor, Surfshark. Now, Surfshark is a fast, easy-to-use VPN full of incredible features that you can install on an unlimited number of devices with one account. Now, most of the time when we talk about VPNs, we're focused on giving yourself security as you travel around the world, but it can do way more than that. Since you can make it look like your IP address is coming from somewhere else in the world, it unlocks geofencing blocks on some content, like some streaming services. But that's not all. Even shopping services will sometimes gate prices based on your location, so you can change your location to make sure that you're getting the best prices. They also have add-ons to their VPN service to unlock things like Surfshark Alert, which will let you know if your email or personal details like passwords have been leaked online in data breaches. Now, right now, they're running a special deal. Use my code UNDECIDED to get up to 4 additional months for free. Surfshark offers a 30-day money-back guarantee, so there's no risk to try it out for yourself. I've been using Surfshark for years and love it. The link's in the description below. Thanks to Surfshark and to all of you for supporting the channel. So why does the Luba 2 have the edge? Well, the base station RTK antenna doesn't need to connect directly to the Mowers charging station. Instead, it communicates wirelessly using LoRa to the charging station, which is a form of long-range wireless technology. That means it only needs its own power outlet to plug into. And Mowers is selling a solar panel accessory so you can place this thing anywhere in the yard that you want to without an outlet. Now, I ordered one to test out, but I'm still waiting for it. Now, in my book, this is the best type of setup because you can put the antenna on the complete opposite side of the house if you need to for a clear line of sight to the sky. Now, that's exactly what I did for my testing setup, but I am planning on mounting it to the house or the fence with the solar panel in the near future, though. Now, once you have a good location figured out, you'll need to run through the setup process using a mobile app. Now, in the case of the Navimo, it detected the mower via Bluetooth right away. Then I followed the steps to get it onto Wi-Fi and also to activate the cellular connection. Now, cell service isn't required for either of these mowers, but it does give some additional security in case someone steals the mower from your backyard. You'll be able to track down where it's been taken to. Even if someone does make it away with your mower, they won't be able to use it because it's locked to your account. Now, the Luba 2 was a little trickier in my initial setup because you have to pair both the mower and the base station RTK antenna, which wasn't exactly clear when I first started. The setup of the mower itself was virtually identical to the Navimo. Bluetooth detection, connect to Wi-Fi, and then install your own SIM card. But I kept hitting a roadblock trying to start mapping my yard due to poor GPS location. That's when I realized that I also had to pair and connect the RTK antenna to my Wi-Fi. And once I did that, everything was able to advance to the mapping your yard step. And mapping for both is pretty straightforward, but also slightly embarrassing as you slowly walk your robot around the yard. It's quite the show for the neighbors. Just a man taking his robot for a walk. Nothing to see here. You drive the mower around the perimeter of each section of yard that you want to mow. You're supposed to keep it about 3 to 6 inches from the edge of the lawn or obstacles where it could get caught up. Now, the Navimo's UI for this needs some work, because it's not really intuitive how to make corrections after the fact. The Luba 2 has a more intuitive UI for creating sections, pathways, and editing them after the fact. For instance, on the Luba 2, it was very easy to create a zone for the side yard, then the front yard, and then create a pathway between the two across the driveway. On the Navimo, I still get warning boxes that I haven't selected an object to edit when trying to make a change. It's really not clear when the map boundary you want to edit is selected or not, so I keep making the same mistake. What about the features? I'm not gonna go feature by feature, but here's a quick high-level comparison chart between the two units that I have. As a former UX designer, I'm not big on the spec sheet checklist comparisons because they don't tell the whole story of what it's actually like to use the product. For instance, it looks damning that the Luba 2 has a shorter runtime compared to the Navimo, but the Luba 2 has all-wheel drive and can easily handle slopes and rougher terrain than the Navimo, which is why it has a shorter runtime. From my experience with both of these units, the runtime is not a big deal at all, considering that you'll likely be running these when you're asleep or doing something else. You won't notice or really care. They'll wander back to their dock to charge up and continue their jobs as needed. Now, where the feature set differences do matter is around noise levels, mowing heights, and slopes. The Navimo is virtually silent when mowing, while the Luba 2 has a noticeable, but still quiet, whirring sound as it makes its way around the yard. And both are quiet enough to run whenever you want without worrying about bothering your neighbors, but the Luba 2 is slightly louder. The Navimo at my old house got stuck easily in a few spots of the yard that had some pretty steep slopes that went past what it could handle. My new yard doesn't have as many steep slopes, so it's handling those like a champ now. However, it still has managed to get itself stuck and wedged against the rock beds along part of the house. Since it's only rear-wheel drive, it doesn't have enough power and traction to get itself out of a jam like that. On the flip side, the all-wheel drive Level 2 is a little powerhouse. It's had zero issues navigating the same types of rock beds if it gets itself into a tricky situation. Now for me, the mowing height is the biggest difference between these two. For a standard lawn, you ideally want to cut the grass to a height between 2 to 3 inches or 50 to 76 millimeters high. And granted, this is going to vary a lot by what your turf is made up of and what the water situation looks like. Taller grass will have a more established root system, which means less watering is needed. That's my biggest problem with the Navimo. The highest it can go is 2.4 inches or 60 millimeters. While that's good enough, I'd prefer to cut my lawn closer to that 3-inch mark or 76 millimeters. The Lubba 2 can go between 1 and 2.75 inches or 20 to 75 millimeters in the base version, but they also have an H for height variant that goes all the way up to 4 inches or 100 millimeters. That's the one that I have. So what's the user experience like actually living with these things? Well, in a word, it's awesome. I have a lawn that looks like a consistent height all the time. All I have to do every week or so is go out with a lawn trimmer and get those areas the robot mowers can't get to. You're talking about spending 15 minutes every week or two trimming the lawn versus a couple of hours every week mowing it. And both mowers have a scheduling function where you can tailor not only the time it mows, but how it will mow the yard, meaning changing the mowing height or direction, what zones to mow. You get the idea. Now, the Navimo has a bit of an edge for this feature because it automatically alternates the mowing direction with each scheduled mow. For instance, on day one, it cuts diagonally to the right, and then on day two, it cuts diagonally to the left. This helps to keep any ruts from forming and also ensures that every blade of grass gets cut over the course of a week. Now, the Lubba 2 doesn't automatically change cutting directions, but you can program in specific cutting patterns for different tasks. Now, while it's not automatic, you can manually get to a somewhat similar place, but I really prefer the way the Navimo handles this one. Now, probably the coolest feature, and the one I'm still trying to figure out what an actual use is for this, is the FPV mode for the Lubba 2. You can watch a first-person perspective video feed from the mower as it mows your yard. It's both insanely cool and yet an incredibly dubious feature. You feel a bit like Honey, I Shrunk the Kids while watching the video feed. Lawnmower! Now, as Paul Hibbert would say, now we have to address the elephant in the room. If you've ever used a robot vacuum cleaner, you'll know that these things are far from perfect. While they do remove the chore of mowing the vast majority of your lawn, they bring along some new, minor fiddliness. You may have to rescue it from time to time when it gets stuck, and it will get stuck. You'll have to hose it down from time to time and change the blades. You'll have to keep the sensors and cameras clean so it can do its job effectively. But all of that isn't the elephant in the room, it's the cost. These things are expensive. The Segway Navimo H starts at $1,899 and goes up to $2,599 at the time of making this video. With the increase in price, you get a mower that's capable of handling a bigger yard. The Mowmotion Lubba 2 starts at $2,099 and goes all the way up to $4,099. Yeah, what's your time worth? Now, while that's crazy expensive, this may make sense for someone that's paying a lawn service to cut their lawn, or for someone that has a hectic schedule and doesn't have time to mow the lawn themselves. Or in my case, you could hate mowing lawns with the fiery passion of 10 suns going supernova. If you don't fall into one of those buckets, then you'd be better off getting a great electric lawnmower and doing it yourself. You can pick up an Ego mower for between $400 and $1,000. I love mine, but if I gotta be honest, I love my little robot lawnmowers more. Now, which one is better? Well, they're equal as far as the cutting quality and reliability, but I'd give the edge to the Navimo for cost, but would recommend the Lubba 2 for the overall feature set, power, and robustness. If you have a large yard with lots of slopes and hills, the Lubba 2 is probably gonna handle it like a champ. So what do you think? Do you welcome our robot overlords, or do you still prefer to do this kind of work yourself? Jump in the comments and let me know, and be sure to listen to my follow-up podcast, Still to be Determined. We'll keep this conversation going. And thanks as always to my patrons for your continued support. I'll see you in the next one.